Hello, beautiful community. This video, I'm doing some toothpick holders. Now that Christmas is finished, I've finished doing the Christmas trees and the Christmas bells and the Christmas baubles and Christmas this and Christmas that. So I thought I'd better make something else because there's another market in February and I don't think anyone would want to be buying any Christmas ornaments. So I thought I'd better start doing a few other things. And I did see somewhere there's some toothpick holders. I thought I'd give them a go. So I've tried using cypress pine, and I grabbed a couple of cypress posts from the local hardware. I cut them into square blocks, they're about 55, 60 millimeters square, and I've had them sitting there for a year or so. And the trouble with the cypress is once you start turning, they start to crack. 12 months ago, I glued up some of the cracks, hoping that that would help, but I found that as soon as I start turning them, they do crack a bit. And then when I was doing one a couple of days ago, I must have put too much pressure on the wood and it just exploded on the lathe. As you can see, I can't really use it for anything, so that'll go straight into the fire. So I've got to be fairly careful when I turn the cypress. I get it down fairly close to where I want to finish it, and then I check it for any cracks. And usually there's one or two cracks there, and I fill them up with CA glue and a bit of the shavings, and that seems to do the trick. But I'll keep persevering with the cypress because it's a beautiful wood. It's got some nice grain and it really makes the toothpick holders pop. But I found with the cypress, I've been using it a couple of times, and usually in the evenings after I've been turning the cypress, I get a runny nose and I get a funny sort of a head and have trouble sleeping. So I've come to the conclusion that I must have an allergy to the cypress, or the cypress dust is giving me an allergy. I do use a full face mask and blows the air in there, so I don't get any dust when I'm turning, but I think once I take the mask off, there's a lot of fine dust in the air and that must have some effect on me. I think these will be the last ones for a little while. I might even try using a bit of she oak or silky oak for the next couple of toothpicks. So anyway, I did three of these ones and I just used three tools. I used the parting tool and the roughing tool and also the half inch spindle gouge. So they were the only tools that I used. Then I finished them off with some tungue oil at the end. After I did these three, I ended up did a few more and I did a few different shapes just to vary it a little bit. As you can see in the photo, I quite like these ones, and I quite like all of them. I like the shapes of them. So I've made 10 of them, and hopefully I might sell one or two of them at the next market in February. So in the meantime, I'll have a hunt around and see what else I can make of the market. So I hope you enjoy this video. I'll see you next time. Cheerio. thought I'd give you a short tour of the shed. I've got a stubby lathe that's made in Melbourne, Australia. It's a beautiful machine. It has a 2-horsepower motor, and I've got it bolted to the floor. It's a fairly heavy duty lathe, and it certainly does the job for me. I've also got a lot of tools that are within arm's length of the lathe, so I don't have to go too far to get the tools and sandpaper and that sort of stuff. Also use the bandsaw. I've got quite a few bowls drying there, and 95% of the wood that I collect, or given the wood, I try not to buy any wood, because I've got probably 2 sheds or a fairly big shed full of wood, and then I've got some outside drying that'll be ready in the next year or so. So I've still got quite a few mistletoes there. Some have been stabilised in this vacuum pot and vacuum pump. I'm still collecting the mistletoe whenever I can find it. So that's a little tour of the shed.